Whenever the devil means to remove power, he goes after the preaching of the cross. And if he knew that he could talk Jesus into saving man without going to the cross, he would never have saved man at all. It would only have looked saved. But the temptation that he said no to, certain ministers said yes to. Because the devil came and said, I'll give you a big church. I'll give you a kingdom with big screens, skinny jeans, and fog machines. And you'll need a golf cart to get to your various campuses. But size matters. And the thing you want is not disciples, but people who come to church. What you want is the money. What you want is the fame. What you want is the best-selling book. And the devil said, here's what I want you to give up. I want you to give up prayer. I want you to give up the anointing. I want you to give up your decision to turn prostitutes and drug addicts into saints of God. I want you to give up trying to get rid of evil in government. I want you to give up preaching the truth that would turn men and women into the powerful people of God. So we got big, powerless churches. Churches that told you, you don't need to vote. You don't need to discuss abortion. And I will not preach on the cross because it'll affect my attendance. Isn't it ironic that these large seeker churches accepted the second temptation that was offered to Christ? They said, yes, I'll take the kingdom. And I will bow down and worship you. And then they said, I'll do it to get a big church, only to end up being shut down by the very government they tolerated. Am I preaching yet? Now, when the righteous do not take their battle station, the wicked are emboldened. You know, Israel in the Old Testament, we're going to read this in a moment. We read 1 Samuel 13. Israel in the Old Testament, they knew, the enemies of Israel knew when they weren't anointed. There was a shout that the Jews had. Of course, they got it from Joshua, and they tried it one time in 1 Samuel chapter 5. They tried to shout, but it was a shout with no clout. And a Philistine noticed it because the Philistines began to run away from the Jewish army in 1 Samuel 5 because they heard them shout the way they did at Jericho. But one of the soldiers in the Philistines noticed something. He said, they are not anointed. See, even the world knows when our music is not anointed. And they noticed, you're under no anointing. This army has no anointing. And he yelled at the men, stop, turn around. Israel is not being protected by God right now. Go and get them. That same thing happened in California when the left was emboldened by preachers who took no stand on abortion, no stand on marriage, no stand at all. And they began to say, you know what? We can beat up the church now. We can stop the church now. We can attack the church now. We can use laws of zoning to keep them from buying buildings. We can get them out of the school. We can take prayer out. Nobody's going to do anything because they are not an army. They are concerned about church growth, not authority over devils, not authority over the power of the enemy. But that day is coming. There's a new breed of pastor rising up right now. Does anybody feel the anointing in this house right now? There's a new breed of pastor coming up. You know, they're going to be able to say, get behind me, Satan. Look at me. Twin evils destroyed California. a compromised church, and an emboldened enemy. And things were dark for Israel when this happened the first time. It says in 1 Samuel 13, verse 22, something that really needs to be preached about. And so it came about on the day of battle that there was no sword or spear found in the hand of any people of Israel. But they were found with Saul and Jonathan his son. I'm going to read that part in a moment. Go back to verse 19 now. 1 Samuel 13, 19. There was no blacksmith found throughout the land of Israel. And the Philistines said, lest the Hebrews make swords and spears. So they lost their Second Amendment right. You're not helping me enough. Because whenever tyranny takes over a land, the first thing they're going to do is close down the blacksmith shop. They're going to get rid of whatever makes a weapon. And the church used to be more than a country club, more than an entertainment center. It used to be a forge that knew how to make weapons and leaders. It knew how to do it, but that was closed down. But there's always a remnant. And sometime that remnant needs to be told who they are. There is a remnant that is sent by God to turn California around. There is a remnant sent by God to turn California around. There is a remnant sent by God to turn California around. Pastor, there are people in your church that don't want it to be fiery, don't want it to be holy, don't want it to be righteous. They threaten to take away their tithe. They told you you can't open up yet. You're going to get people infected. They don't realize they are the infection. There's got to be an hour, there's got to be a day when a man or a woman of God stands in a pulpit and says, this is the day that we become the devil's worst nightmare in the state of California. This is when you feel the pain, devil. This is when you know that God's people have awakened. How many of you are glad we're opened up again, shoulder to shoulder in church? So what do we do to get the state back? Listen to the preacher. A whole generation was cursed by a twin evil, a lukewarm leadership, and an aggressive enemy. Don't think for a moment that this pandemic lockdown had anything to do with the virus. You know it every time you get on a jet plane, sitting shoulder to shoulder with people. And you're wondering, why can we sit shoulder to shoulder on an airplane but not in a church? Because this had nothing to do with the pandemic. It had to do with an aggressive anti-Christian spirit. That's what it's all about.